Merry Christmas to you and your dear ones. Today I want to share three things with you. One is about universal values, cosmic rules. Two is about inside and outside. And three is about three suggestions. Okay, Merry Christmas, special time Christmas, especially this year. This is our family. Nicole is in Long Beach, California. Joyce is in Amsterdam, the Netherlands, and Mary unfortunately left us on the 8th of August from this planet. She's on the 888th lucky Chinese numbers floor right now. And I'm here in Antwerp. Now, what do we have in common as a wonderful family? Actually, we have more not in common if you look at the normal things. We are multilingual, multinational, multiracial, multicultural, multireligious. But behind there, in the core of the core, we have universal values, universal principle, cosmic rules that are all the same everywhere. I remember vividly in March 2001, Mary and I were in Pakistan. I had the pleasure and honor to give three different workshop masterclasses there, in Karachi, in Islamabad, and in Lahore. We made a tour around Pakistan, fully protected with several cars. That's a longer story. And we were in the border town, Pakistan-Afghanistan, in Peshawar. There we visited a beautiful big mosque. And I remember as if it were yesterday that in the third alcove on the right side, there were about 15 boys studying there and reciting and singing from the Quran with the teacher. They all, of course, wear a little hat on top. And I felt tears coming. Why did I feel tears coming? Because not long before that, we visited Israel. And on the Wailing Wall, also on the right side, there were about 15 boys with a teacher, with a yarmulke on, reciting from the Old Testament, from the Torah, and singing from it. And when I close my eyes there in Peshawar, and I hear it now, the tone of voice, the sounds, the intonation, the whole experience was very, very similar. And I thought to myself, it's all basically the same. And it is. If you look at Jesus, where Christmas is, of course, all about, Jesus Christ, Christmas, the Mass of Christ. So it's not about the institutions behind a man like Jesus. Because Jesus or Abraham or Buddha or Mohammed or Vishnu, if you look all at these people that we see as sort of enlightened, they all had the same message. Love, deeper happiness, bliss, understanding the larger context. So please, with Christmas, focus on those universal principles. You don't have to study the Ten Commandments to know them. That software was on your hardware when you were born, when you came out as a laptop, as a baby. It's there. And you know, if you do something that is not correct, a little light will flash on and off, so to say, on your internal dashboard. You recognize that? So that's my first point. Please tune into the universal values. My second point is inside and outside. Christmas is a wonderful time of the year where we enjoy and all kinds of things. You know, we really enjoy with our five traditional earthly physical senses: hearing, seeing, smelling, tasting, feeling, looking good, having good food, nice conversations. But that's basically all on the outside that brings happiness to the inside. What Christmas is really about, as far as I'm concerned, and this year I especially get invited to do so with Mary now from a different dimension, is what happens on the inside. And what insights do you get? We adore and admire people like Nelson Mandela and Mahatma Gandhi. Why? These guys, at a certain moment, they could not look outside. There was no outside. They were in prison. So the only place they could look literally and figuratively is inside. And they got a lot of insights. And those insights help us for reconciliation, for accepting things, for letting things go. So please make the right balance. Let Christmas not only be something that you look outside to what should happen and how do I look. Enjoy the earthly dimensions, but look at the deeper insights. And the third thing I want to mention in this little Christmas video are actually three suggestions that all old traditions, philosophy, religions of the world suggest to you, to us, to you and to me. Firstly, do not judge. Do not judge somebody else. And do not judge yourself. Wow, that's a biggie, right? Secondly, unconditional love towards the other and towards yourself. If you do not love yourself, how can you expect somebody else to love you? If your bottle is not full, if your battery is not full, if you drive your car with an empty tank, you're not going anywhere. And thirdly, forgive the other and yourself. Well, a big one. So anybody finish with that? Non-judgment, completely unconditional love and forgiving, you can leave. Who knows, that's the reason why Mary could leave. She's probably now sitting right very close to her buddy, Jesus Christ, and at the source of all sources. And I feel her presence, and she sends you love for sure. Well, that's what I wanted to share right now for Christmas. I want to wish you a wonderful Christmas, and I'll talk to you next week with New Year. Bye-bye.